6-11. And we're almost set to get this one underway. And here we go. Controlled by Northwestern State is Michael Byers Dawson out of Fort Worth Dunbar. Operates out front working on Junior Blunt. It's a nice screen out top of the circle from Fisher. Has it, works it down low to Fisher now. Nice give and go for the lay-in that's rejected by Corey Bowson. The shot attempt by Chris Lynch in the forecourt. Blunt for three. Too strong on the attempt. Bowson is undercut. Looks like he's okay, though, on the rebound. And here comes McCray in the forecourt now. Fires Dawson off the corner. Swings it around for the long jumper. A three that won't go for Chris Lynch. And a push-off on the rebound by Alan Polk. And the Frogs see Northwestern State pick up their first team foul to start the ball game.
And Northwestern State immediately going to the three-point shot. Watching in them shooting drills, they come down to a lot of dribble penetration, kick the ball out to the perimeter for the three.
Just underway here the first half. No score between TCU and Northwestern State. Bowson left side. Bowson to the elbow, stops, kicks it out in the corner. Santee for three, short on the attempt. Bouncing, rebound, put back, won't go. Fisher tips it out, tapped around and finally controlled out now by Chris Lynch. Lynch will find his point guard, Michael Byers Dawson, across the timeline. Has it to the right wing, works on Junior Blunt. Frogs open and man-to-man. Out front, they swing it around now to Fisher. Fisher, left elbow, working on Dumont. The 6'11 center turns and shoots on the elbow over Dumont and knocks it down.
Fisher bobbled ball that time. Dumont went after it. Fisher just spun on him and made the shot.
Down low, Dumont. It scores.
Great pivot that time to pivot baseline to shoot a little right-hand layup.
Tied at two apiece, 18:42 to play. Byers Dawson in the backcourt, working on Junior Blunt. Tied at two here between TCU and Northwestern State. Byers Dawson dribbles to the left-hand side. Picks up his dribble. Out front now it comes to Fisher. Fisher looks down low for McCray. Instead out top it comes now to Alan Polk. Polk, the senior out of Emerson, Arkansas, sends it off now to McCray. Gerald McCray on the move. Partially blocked by Dumont. Tipped in the air. Bouncing goes high. Can't bring it down. And I got a feeling Corey going to be whistled for the personal foul. Maybe Jamal Brown, I should say. Whistled for the personal. That'll be his first. And team foul number one of the Frogs.
So active on both ends of the glass here early, deflecting loose basketballs on both ends.
Polk to trigger the inbounds. Does so to McCray. McCray down low off the glass. Can't get it to go, but an offensive foul. Nice job. He used his left arm for an advantage.
Well, he cleared out Jamal Brown. When you can make Jamal Brown move about 2 feet midair, you've done some clearing out.
Now Brown will trigger the inbounds. A little pressure to backcourt as picking up Corey Santee as a senior, Alan Polk. Santee, just a freshman out of Michigan, takes it to the rack, has it rejected by DeOra Fisher. We mentioned he had 13 blocks in one game last year.
And you have to go at him like that, but Corey can go in and get a little piece of Fisher and maybe get the foul call.
Blunt off the inbounds for three, good. Trey for Junior Blunt with the Frogs with the first lead at 5-2.
Great perimeter shooter, Junior Blunt.
Under 8 minutes to play in this first half. Polk across the timeline, working on Corey Santee. Looks right side out front, almost stolen. It is stolen. Jamal Brown has it in the forecourt. Took it away by McCray. McCray took it away from Jamal Brown. It goes out of bounds, and they say it goes off of Jamal Brown.
Jamal Brown doing a great job on the perimeter under the nice situation, but he got bumped all the way down the floor. Billy still wanting the call.
So Northwestern State will have it in the backcourt. Michael Byers Dawson works on Junior Blunt. Takes it across the timeline. Dawson, free throw line out of Polk, turns, hands it off McCray. Nice move to the rack over to Mott off the glass, scores. A lot of contact, Dumont trying to draw the charge. But the bucket will count it as 5-4. TCU making 8-4 as in rhythm is Junior Blunt already with his second three of the night.
And Brian, the key there is in rhythm because when he gets into that rhythm, he's going to knock it down.
DeOra Fisher in the backcourt. They don't want the ball in his hands. He finds his point guard now. Michael Byers Dawson and the head coach of Northwestern State, Mike McConathy, waves Fisher down the floor. The line now with it is Polk who tries to send it off to Michael Byers Dawson who takes a timeout, a 30-second timeout, 17:01 to play. Frogs have rolled out 8 points in just over a minute 20.
Michael Byers Dawson reminds me so much of Mike Jones who played here at TCU, and actually Mike Jones is now playing in Italy.
Bob Hughes to the 13 that Herb had.
13-13. That's not bad. But that's close to over 600 apiece the way I divided up.
What was that line about the North Carolina graduates who make the most money? What was their major? It was geography because of Michael Jordan's contract.
trick. Left elbow with it now on the move is Dior Fisher, and off the glass at Warnko. The rebound out of Jamal Brown. They'll give it up in the forecourt. Santee, long lead pass. Dumont catches, puts it up, blocked by Fisher. Off in the hands, now to Polk. Polk in the forecourt sends it off to Byers Dawson. Dawson left wing, backs up, shoots a J, in and out. Rebound Fisher, put it back with one hand, and he's fouled on the way up. Right now, Northwestern State is using Fisher as to screen out at the high post, and that frees him up once the ball shot just crashed the board from about 18 feet. Somebody's got to put a body on him, not let him get in there and be able to run and jump simultaneously.
Free throw line is Dior Fisher. Fisher's first effort is up and good. 3 points on the night. 6'11" center, Dior Fisher. Into the lineup now comes Colin Boddicker. Checks in for Corey Bowson. Boddicker, the senior out of Duncanville, as Fisher makes them both. 8-6, Horned Frogs lead it here by two, with 16:38 to play here in this first half at Daniel Meyer Coliseum. Santee out front with it, hands it off now to Junior Blunt. Blunt on the right-hand side, down low now to Dumont. Works on Big Fisher, uses his left hand nicely, lays it up and scores, does Marla Dumont.
Spinning baseline, coming up and actually shooting the ball left-handed on the right-hand side.
In the backcourt now, Michael Byers Dawson. He almost lost the handle on it, does. Blunt picks his pocket. It'll be Blunt coast-to-coast for the lay-in goal.
Michael Byers Dawson that time losing his footing up around half court.
8 points for Junior Blunt. Marlon Dumont's four, and that's all the Frogs need. They lead it 12-6. Out front, Dawson feeds it off with a lay-in. And that will count and a foul. And credit Chris Lynch with the bucket. Colin Boddicker tried to draw the charge, but a little late sliding in, and Lynch will go to the line now.
And good call, Brian. 3-on-1 that time. Colin had to make a choice. He chose to actually lean to his left, which is Northwestern State's right, got over to the left. His left, their right, a little late, and the foul was called correctly so.
Free throw line now goes Chris Lynch, a senior out of Cedar Hill.
And all that left-right, I think I feel like I'm in the Army all of a sudden.
Free throw is up and good for Lynch, and it brings us to a timeout of the floor. 15:57 to play here in the first half. TCU 12, Northwestern State 9. Back we come to Daniel Meyer after we take this effort timeout.
I love the internet. You know why? I'll tell you why. I like websites. I like email.
Coming up from behind, the last block was swatted out of bounds, and people not anticipating that. Once again, go in there strong and tough. Make him go for the block. Take the ball to him. Make him foul you.
After the timeout, Horned Frogs will have possession of it. Junior Blunt. Out front, it comes down to Colin Boddicker. Left-hand side, Santee for three going. Corey, the freshman, to the tray.
A great job at TCU executing to perfection the play once the ball comes down floor.
15:43 to play in this first half.
And that's typical of Billy's clubs. He calls the timeout. Coming out of the timeout, they have the ball the first down. They execute the play. And Corey Santee's wide open from about 20 feet.
11 points for the starting backcourt of the Frogs. Santee and Blunt quickly in the forecourt. McCray moves in on Dumont at the left baseline. Sends it back out front. Byers Dawson off to Fisher. Fisher back out front. Stolen away by Blunt. Second steal of the night for Junior. Junior in the forecourt. Pulls up. 17-footer. Short. Boddicker goes high. Can't bring it down. Rebound off the Polk now. They'll give it off to Fisher. Fisher right back to Alan Polk, his point guard. Works it across the timeline. Out front it comes Fisher for three. It's 6'11". He knocked it down. Wow.
He double-clutched that in midair, and I don't know if that's a shot they necessarily want him to take, but no hesitation whatsoever.
15-12, a three-point advantage now for TCU over Northwestern State. 7 points for Fisher. He's got 7 of their 12. Blunt tried to force it down low and stolen away on the entry by Byers Dawson. In the forecourt comes Michael Byers Dawson. Crossover leaves Blunt, sends it cross court now to Corey, Chris Lynch, I should say. Down low, turnaround, won't go. McCray there for the rebound for the follow goal.
Five Frogs standing and watching.
15-14, a one-point lead, a 5-0 run for Northwestern State right now. Frogs are leading it here by just that single digit. Boddicker, right side now. Santee for three. This one won't go, and Colin, a stupid foul in the backcourt.
And the bad thing about what's taking place right now, the Frogs are relying totally on the outside game. And when this happens, you are no offensive threat inside. And you don't have anyone to rebound either. The ball's got to go inside at some point.
Second personal on Colin Boddicker. Team foul number four on the Frogs here in the first half. We'll see James Davis for the first time checking the lineup. He's going to come in for Corey Santee. In for
Northwestern State, Melvin Roberts, a 6'6 senior out of Vosburgh, Mississippi.
And Junior Blunt will probably move over to the point.
Also into the lineup now comes Michael Edwards, a sophomore out of Rowlett, and Ryan Duplessis, a senior out of New Orleans. So a couple of substitutions for Northwestern State. Also Darnell Bradley out there, four substitutions. And tapping away the inbound entry was Jamal Brown. Also into the lineup is Corey Wilson. The blue team's out there now. It's five new players for Northwestern State. Edwards in the backcourt, puts it up now to Corey Wilson. His guard is double-teamed by the Frogs. Off it comes now to Duplessis. Duplessis, who was a starting point guard 2 years ago, gets it in the forecourt now. Shot clock was at 23. Here's an easy lay-in after the entry now by Melvin Roberts. In the forecourt with it now, James Davis. Pump fakes a three, brings it back down, spins it out to Blunt. Spotted for the three. In and out on the attempt. Marlon Dumont keeps it alive, brings it down, throws it up, can't get it to go, but draws a foul with 13:58 to play in the first half. And the Frogs trailing it by one at 16:50.
And I think the last time that Northwestern State took the ball out of bounds, it was only 33 seconds because it was deflection two times and bringing the ball in. But Billy was looking up at the shot clock and saw that number.
Free throw line now goes Marlon Dumont. Marlon last year, 73% free throw shooter.
And once again, the Frogs relying on the jump shot.
First one's too strong. Senior out of Kingston, Jamaica is Marlon Dumont. Who, by the way, the tragedy of September 11 struck home with him. Marlon lost a brother in the World Trade Center. Second effort is up and good for DeMont. 13:58 to play in the first half. Tied at 16 now between TCU and Northwestern State. In the backcourt with it is Corey Wilson. Wilson across the timeline now. Flips it up the left-hand side to Duplessis. Works baseline, put the glass high. Can't get it to go, but the rebound following short from Edwards. Melvin Edwards' third attempt is up and good. Melvin Roberts, I should say. Gets credit for the bucket. It's 18-16 now, Northwestern State. Santee, forecourt, Boddicker. Spotted to three. Collins short on the attempt. Rebound cleared out of there now by Corey Wilson. Frogs trailing it 18-16. Wilson to the forecourt, Duplessis. At the left baseline, sends it back out front now. As they spin it around to Bradley. Bradley threw it away. Off in the corner, looking for Ryan Duplessis. Turns it over to the Frogs with 13-21 to play. And that one, the fifth turnover of the night.
And once again, Ryan Duplessis was right open in the corner. That ball was just picked up and thrown about 10 feet over his head.
13-18 to play in the hand. Colin Boddicker, left-hand side, out front, out of James Davis. Davis to Blunt. They tried to force it down low. Jamal Brown was pushed down. I think he may have been a wet spot. It goes out of bounds, though, off of Northwestern State.
Did slip in a wet spot that time, got their feet caught up and went to the floor, and luckily Northwestern State deflected the basketball.
Frogs have not scored in the last 2 minutes and 38 seconds. A field goal, that is. They have scored on the free throw attempt by Marlon Dumont. 13-10 to play. 18-16, I think. Frogs trailing it by two. James Davis gets the entry pass on the inbounds, has it out front, looks for Colin, had it slapped away, but flips it over to Colin Boddicker now to Junior Blunt, right-hand side to Davis. Down low goes Jamal Brown. Brown backs in, spins in, turns, and travels.
Yeah, picked the ball at that time and picked up his left foot, his pivot foot that time. They caught him for a travel. Actually took two steps before he shot the basketball.
Second turnover of the night for the Horned Frogs. 12:58 to play. Boddicker gets tied up at half court, trailing his man, Corey Wilson. Wilson sends it back out front now. Operating as a point guard is Michael Edwards. Edwards to Duplessis. Bingo Merrick's going to get into the next dead ball. Left-hand side to Corey Wilson. Back out it comes now to Michael Edwards. Now to 12:39 to play in the first half. Frogs trailing at 18-16. Out front is Wilson. Wilson out of Duplessis. The Frogs have changed the defense on Northwestern State. It's confused with a tad. Darnell Bradley back out front. Duplessis, 18-footer inside the arc. Short. Boddicker can't get the rebound. The tip follow is good by Darnell Bradley.
Boddicker must get that rebound. He's got to put a body on someone, go up, secure the basketball, try to grab it one hand at a time.
20-16 now. Frogs down by four. Here's Junior Blunt in the lane and is fouled on his way in on penetration.
Once again, Boddicker had backside rebound. If he just steps back a little bit and makes contact, he gets the board as opposed to having the tip in over his back.
Personal foul, by the way, was whistled on Corey Wilson. Jamal Brown and Colin Boddicker check out. Into the lineup comes Corey Santee and Bingo Merricks for the first time tonight. An
7-1 run by Northwestern State. They now lead it by four at 20-16. Santee looked down low for Bingo. Got his man posted up. Bingo catches it at the low block. Takes it strong to the rack. Had it slapped away. And trampled. Minutes to play in the half, 20-16. Rocks trailing it here by four. Double team in the backcourt. But now Corey Wilson clears it up in the forecourt to Ryan Duplessis. Drawn to the rack of Vermont, spins in and a travel. Brings us to a timeout of the floor. 11:51 to play in this first half. Northwestern State 20, TCU 16. Back we come to Daniel Meyer Coliseum after we take this network time. Special guest, one Bob Hughes, the head coach of Dunbar, Herb.
Yeah, Brian, great opportunity here to talk to Coach Hughes from Dunbar High School. Viewing one of his stellar performers in Michael Pye, as we used to call him. Coach, what do you think about his performance thus far?
I think he's doing a pretty good job, except I'd like to see him shoot it a couple more times.
That's sort of your philosophy at Dunbar. I know that. Your team's played great defense as well.
He's playing great defense. He's doing a good job of running the point. But sometimes if your point's one of your best scores, you kind of have to turn him loose and let him do it.
And you did that, did you?
You betcha.
Good luck this year, Coach.
Thank you.
There you have it. Herb Stevens with Bob Hughes at Dunbar. 20-16. As you mentioned, Herb early on talked 1,300 career victories for Bob Hughes. Bingo Marich with the first shot attempt of the 2001 season for him. It's off the glass, and the rebound now comes down to Ryan Duplessis, who'll take it coast to coast. His layup won't go, but a foul on the rebound here. 11:22 to play. 20-16. Horned Frogs trailing it here to Northwestern State. Michael Edwards, the trigger of the inbounds. Does so out now to Ryan Duplessis. Duplessis out front, it comes to Corey Wilson. Wilson down low, they swing the basketball around now as Melvin Roberts in the lane lost the handle on it. James Davis with the rebound. Davis off to Corey Santee. Santee back to Davis. Davis in the lane, tried to drop it off for Bingo Marich. Blunt picks it up. Back to Davis. Davis, 18-footer. The corner good, and he's knocked down as he lets go. It counts 20-18 now. Frogs within two. Long lead passes caught and scored on the lay-in by Darnell Bradley. 22-18. Frogs back up by, or trailing it again by four. 10:48 to go. Blunt to the rack is fouled on his way in before the shot. The bucket, by the way, by James Davis, stopped a 4:47 drought. And we get the original starting five back in the lineup now for Northwestern State. 22-18, Northwestern State leading. Herb Stevens back courtside. Did you get a workout?
Much more than I wanted.
You did good.
Well, can't we have them come over here? I have to run everywhere.
He's got 1,300 wins, man. You go see him.
Good point. I will go over see Coach Hughes.
Junior Blunt on the right side. Look down low for Bingo Marich. Bingo now has it out of the top of the circle. Back to Santee. Down low, not a Blunt. Blunt down low to Dupont. Reverse layup won't go, but he's fouled by Deora Fisher.
And a good job that time. Marlon actually took the ball to Deora Fisher, and Fisher's going to try to block everything and caught him with the body.
DeMont on the line right now. Fans, the Frogs will make two appearances on K-Star 49, two on KFWD TV 52 here in the Metroplex this year, part of the ESPN Plus Network. Tuesday, December 18th, the Frogs take on SMU. You can see it on K-Star 49. And Saturday, December 29th, Frogs face the Baylor Bears in K-Star. Then in the new year against Conference USA foes on Channel 52, they'll take on South Florida on January 5, UAB on February 12. TC basketball on K-Star, KFWD, and ESPN Plus brought to you by Miller Brewing of Fort Worth. First free throw attempt by Marlon Dumont is good. 22-19, make it 22-20 now as he made them both. 10:34 to play in this first half. Frogs trail it by two. Deora Fisher in the backcourt, lost the handle on it, got it back, should have been a trap.
He traveled twice, I think. The first time he caught it, then right in front of it.
Michael Byers-Dawson has it slapped away by Dumont, and Northwestern State will retain possession of it.
And what the official is saying, if you don't have control of the basketball, you can't walk, but he actually bobbled it, or actually had the basketball and walked and then bobbled it.
I was used as an excuse, okay? I don't have control of it.
Yeah, that's true.
You see the dribble out front. Now they send it right-hand side. Is Chris Lynch. Lynch off to McCray. Now Michael Byers-Dawson in the lane. Knifes through, lays it up. Can't get it to go. Undercut is Bingo Marich in the lane, but a foul here on the rebound. I think it's going to be on Deora Fisher. Let's see. Yep, Fisher going to be whistled for the personal foul.
Yeah, a scary moment that time because Deora Fisher actually rolled up on top of Bingo's leg. It looked like he could have hurt him once again.
Deora Fisher. Picks up his second personal foul. Team foul number five in the front. Excuse me, on Northwestern State, team foul number seven. Deora Fisher's second. Got it straight. Free throw line, Bingo Merricks for 1-1. Short on the first free throw attempt. Dumont tips the rebound out, but it's controlled by Polk. Polk across the timeline on CNT. 10 minutes to play in the half. Left-hand corner swings it out and a foul. Chris Lynch was fouled by James Davis of the Frogs. That'll be his first, team six.
James Davis actually reaching in to try to deflect the basketball. Poke on the arm. They caught him for a touch foul on the perimeter.
Out of trigger the inbounds is Byers-Dawson. Does so out front to Lynch. Lynch works in on Santee, sends it back right-hand side for the long jumper that won't go for Melvin Roberts. It goes out of bounds and the Frogs will have it. 9:49 to play in this first half. Frogs trailing at 22-20. Northwestern State. Davis out to Bingo Merricks. Merricks left-hand side to Santee. Santee dribbles to the top of the circle with the right elbow, keeps his dribble alive, running one-hander, one good, but he draws a foul here on the Demons.
And two things with Deora Fisher out of the game right now. One, you can actually take the ball inside and challenge because they have 6'6", 6'7", players on the floor. The other thing, which is what Corey Santee just did, he took the basketball to the hole because Fisher's not in there to swat it away.
Three throws up and good for Santee. Personal foul, by the way, was on Alan Polk, his second. Corey will have a second effort. Corey Santee on the night, down 4 points. Make it five. Makes them both. Tied at 22, 9:33 to go in the half.
And good recognition that time by Corey to split the two defenders to get all the way to the hoop.
Gray in the backcourt, now to Polk. Polk off to Byers-Dawson. He'll work on Blunt. Left-hand side with it. Sends it back out front now. Chris Lynch. Lynch bounce pass down to McCray. Got Bingo Merricks to the air. Leans into it. Trap. A lot of contact, too, though. Could have gone either way, Herb.
Well, he actually faked Bingo up in the air and then leaned into him. Nothing was called. Not much contact. But the other thing, this lane is extended. We're using an NBA lane in these first games, and he was in there a long time. I didn't spend that much time in the state park last year.
Right-hand side with it is Junior Blunt. Blunt trying to work baseline. Does so out front. Now to Bingo Merricks on the pass. Bingo down low now to Marlon Dumont. Backs in, turns, and shoots the jump hook.
I had a two-day pass on my day.
8:55 to play in the first half, 24-22.
And expect the Frogs to take the ball inside now just because Fisher's out of the game.
The extended lane is one of the NBA rules that the Frogs are experimenting with and it's part of this Las Vegas Invitational. A player control foul will result in possession of the ball, no longer shooting the free throws. Out front is McCray, works on Bingo Merricks, tries to take it to the elbow, back out front, it comes now to Lynch. Lynch off, it comes now to Edwards for the B. Jumper good. Take it to Melvin Robinson. Keep on calling Melvin Edwards.
Yeah, and it took him a long time to get that off, but he made that shot look well. The one previous that bounced over the backboard.
Three-pointer, 25-24 now. Northwestern State by one. James Davis out between the circles, not a Merricks. Bingo down low to Marlon Dumont. Backs in and stolen away by Byers-Dawson. Still loose, and Byers-Dawson comes up with a nice touch pass. Polk for the way in, then won't go, but the follow is good by Melvin Roberts of Northwestern State. 27-24, a three-point Demon lead. Blunt for three. Back of the iron, no good. Rebound, McCray. Grabs a hold of it and slows things down as he hands it off to his point guard, Michael Byers-Dawson.
Quick shot once again, okay in rhythm, but the Frogs have got to hit the boards on that.
Byers-Dawson, left-hand corner, he sends it off now to Lynch, who forces it up and draws the foul. 7:38 to play. Whistled for the personal foul, his first, team foul number seven, and to the line now we'll go Chris Lynch, a senior out of Cedar Hill.
And he catches the basketball in the low post area on the left side of the lane and actually takes it and jumps into the Frogs. The foul's called. Good opportunity to try to take it in there and draw that foul.
Transferred from UC Santa Barbara. First one's up and good. He goes from being a blank to a demon. It wasn't hurt.
what you just said, isn't it?
A gaucho.
Oh, I thought it was like a bad word. You're not going to catch me saying that on the radio.
Free throw line now is Lynch with his second effort. 7:38 to play. Here in this first half, Northwestern State leading at 28-24. Got some moisture on the floor as the ball boys jump out.
We went from having one last week to four tonight.
The full complement.
Yes.
16-7 rebound advantage for the Demons.
Well, and a lot of that's because TCU is shooting so many perimeter shots, the ball's bouncing long, and the Demons are securing the rebounds and running with it. And then on the inside, they're actually hitting the offensive glass pretty well.
Free throws up and good. A 7-0 run right now for the Demons. 7:38 to play in the half. Our score, Northwestern State 29, TCU 24. And back we come to Daniel Meyer after we take this network timeout. Peter in good hands with Allstate. 7:38 to play in this first half. The score, Northwestern State 29, TCU 24 after the timeout.
And to come back and take offensive control of this game, I think TCU needs to go back and do what they do best, get the basketball inside. If it doesn't open up there, kick it out and shoot the shot. The Frogs should execute a play extremely well here.
After the timeout, Corey Santee across the timeline. Junior Blount on the right-hand side. Out now to Corey. Santee between the circles, left-hand side to Davis, penetrates, pitches. Now to Santee for three. Short on the attempt. Davis tries to save it, slaps it out of bounds, and the Demons get it.
Well, the Demons changed up defenses that time. Went into the zone, and the Frogs weren't quite patient enough.
Now the Frogs will show some pressure in the backcourt on Northwestern State. Michael Byers-Dawson gives it off now to Lynch, right back to Byers-Dawson. He works on Blount across the timeline. Corey Valson set to get into the TCU lineup after the dead ball. Byers-Dawson out front now to Roberts. Roberts left-hand side to McCray. McCray out front now to Polk. Back it goes now to McCray. McCray in the corner, back to Polk. Top of the circle now. Off in the corner, they send it to Byers-Dawson. Spotted up for the jumper. Back of the iron, no good. Rebound, Polk had it. Lost it. Run down now by Chris Lynch. 29-24. Northwestern State leading it by five. 6:45 to play in this first half. Between the circles, McCray. Right-hand side, he gives it now to Lynch. Lynch in the lane. Lynch, knife through. Off the glass, no good. Davis with the board. And is knocked down from behind in pursuit of the rebound. McCray going to be whistled for the personal foul for Northwestern State. His second, team foul number nine on the team.
At that time, Jamal Brown actually stood up and tried to take the charge. Got bumped out of the way. That left James Davis only. If he doesn't get fouled, then the Demons are going to have the opportunity to put the basketball back in the hole. But James Davis, very active inside, securing the rebound.
Davis at the line now for 1-1. First one no good. Brown goes over the back trying to get the rebound over McCray. Going to be whistled for the personal. For Jamal Brown, his first, team foul number eight on the Frogs. Season tickets for all TCU basketball games now available. Make your reservations via Daniel Meyer Coliseum or to follow the home Frogs on the road. Call the athletic ticket office at 817-257-FROG. Reserve your seat today.
That time, Jamal Brown, I think, did a nice job actually going after the rebound on the offensive end, committed the foul. There was no doubt about that. But you have to be active enough to go after the basketball to make the Demons work rebounding.
Free throw line now, McCray, 1-1, first and good. Frogs amidst the front end of both of their 1-1. McCray knocks that one down there. Gerald McCray out of Nashville. Makes a second one as well. A 9-0 run. Northwestern State, Marlon Dumont.
Comes in for Bingo Merricks. Merricks leaves.
Well, no points.
But he was active. He got the move, and he's getting the work into getting his game shape completely different than practice and moved pretty well out there.
31-24. Frogs trailing it here by seven. Valson finds the open man, Marlon Dumont, with a little block trap.
They did. He got in a hurry. He faked that time. What anyone around him, if he catches the ball and shoots it, he probably scores. Northwestern State's confused the Frogs a little bit with that zone. Marlon Dumont was open on the right-hand side. The pass was. He did a little bit of a shot fake. No.
31-24, Frogs trailing. 6:21 to play in the hand. Northwestern State with possession. McCray in the forecourt. Down the left hand out. Keeps his dribble alive and flips it out front. Now to Polk. Polk works on Santee. Back out it comes now to McCray on Jamal Brown, and we've got a whistle away from the ball and a foul here. And I think this one's going to go on Melvin Roberts, a senior out of Vosburg, Mississippi.
I think they might have called 3 seconds. He was in an extended lane, never lane.
Santee, left-hand side. Santee to the free throw line, off now to Blunt. Blunt in the corner to Valson for the jumper that won't go. The rebound now as Valson was tackled off in the corner by McCray. Rebound now to Northwestern State. That was a three-second violation on Roberts, not a push. Here's a penetrating, a pitch to Lynch for three that won't go. Rebound now to Jamal Brown. This is a pretty physical ball game, Herb.
Yes, it is, and what has to take place here is the Frogs have got to step up because you know you're going to see this in Conference USA.
DeMont, turnaround, baseline, no good. Rebound followed by Jamal Brown, won't go. Tip followed by Marla DeMont, no good. The rebound down to McCray. Frogs can't buy a bucket right now with 5:24 to play.
But if you continue to do that, you will be able to get them cheaply.
31-24, 5:18 to go. That was Jamal Brown's first field goal attempt. Maybe a second. Left-hand side with it is Polk. He'll pull up, shoot the jumper, and score it from 17 feet. Allen Polk stretches the lead out now, 33-24. 9-point margin for the Demons, their largest of the game. 4:58 to go. Blunt left alone for three, and that'll go.
He got
Blunt
knocked
is down again. 33-27, a 6-point lead. 1 minute and 4 second drought for the Frogs. Stopped there by the three-pointer by Blunt. Right-hand side is Polk. Polk out front now. Gives it to Roberts. He works in on Marlon Dumont. Back left-hand side. They'll swing it around to Lynch. Lynch top of the circle. McCray left alone for the jumper that won't go. Corey Valson was pushed from behind but tapped the ball to Santee on his way through. Santee's pass to Blunt in the corner. Penetrates does Junior. Sends it back out to Corey. Had it slapped away. Taken away. But there's Corey Valson to strip it and tip it to Santee that won't go. His jumper from 10 feet. The rebound down to Roberts. Santee just one of six from the field.
And there's an opportunity for him to do a dribble penetration, actually give the ball to one of the big guys, but pulled up to shoot the 15-footer.
McCray right-hand side now gives it to Byers-Dawson. Nice crossover off the glass and scores. And Michael Byers-Dawson left Junior Blunt his weight.
And we've seen him do that same move twice. He has a very nice crossover.
35-27, 3:45 to go in this first half. Free throw line with it is now Fausten. Strong move to the rack. Dumont there to fall.
Good job of Marlon Dumont just standing in position to actually put the basketball about. Corey Valson taking the ball to the basket hard.
35-29, a 6-point Demon lead. 3:25 to play in this first half. Byers-Dawson, right wing, pulls up, fires a three. Short, rebound. Lost out of bounds. Off of Northwestern State, the Frogs will have it after the timeout. 3:19 to play in this first half. The score, Northwestern State 35. The 13th.
And Northwestern State bringing back most of their offense. Last night last year against the Frogs, they only scored 69, but 51 of those points were scored by three of the guys starting tonight. TCU, the last several times down the floor, at least two people were going to the boards extremely hard, and even when the ball went out of bounds off Northwestern State, two Frogs actually got to the basketball.
Left-hand side with it is Junior Blunt. Blunt penetrates to the lane, shoots the layup. A little short. Brown is there for the rebound. Follow good for Jamal Brown.
And we hope we see Jamal Brown do that a lot this year.
Only the seventh two-point field goal of the night for TC with his first half. 2:57 to play. 35-31. Frogs within four. And they've changed their defense again, Herb.
They've gone to a 1-3-1, putting Corey out at the point where Bingo played last year.
Left-hand corner, Ryan Duplessis. Left alone for three. Good.
They backpicked that 1-3-1 that time. Ryan Duplessis was wide open.
In the backcourt is now Corey Santee operating as the point guard for the Frogs. Working on Duplessis, left-hand side, now to Valson. Valson flips it down low, Marlon Dumont. Dumont backs in and is bumped from behind by Melvin Roberts. That'll be his first.
And Marlon Dumont has a distinct advantage in there, about 3 inches in height, putting the ball on the floor, power dribble going back toward the middle, and Melvin Roberts just forearms him in the back.
Dumont of the line. Dumont on the night. 3 of 4 from the stripe, making 3 of 5.
looking very unsure of himself right now. Just shot that basketball, no follow through whatsoever, was almost hoping that it would go in. After it was released and up in the air about a foot, he brought his hand back in disgust.
Here's Dumont's second free throw attempt. A little bit better on that one, and it goes in. Billy Tubbs going to take a 30-second timeout with 2:29 to play in this first half. TCU trailing at 38-32 to Northwestern State. Let's check in.
That game's tied up 10-10 very early on, and Tulane playing their neighbor Loyola. They're in New Orleans tonight, and the Wave leading 16-3 early in that ball game. Send you back to Daniel Meyer Coliseum. Here's Brandon Herb.
2:25 to go in the first half here with the Frogs trailing at 38-32 to Northwestern State. Off in the corner with the basketball now is Darnell Bradley. Threw it away on the entry. And the Frogs get a break there. They'll get possession of it.
And he had a man wide open that time, just threw about a 55-mile-an-hour pass from 3 feet.
2:13 to play in the hand. Right-hand side punt, catches, fires a three, too strong, rebound Marlon Dumont. Dumont, baseline, turn off the glass, can't get it to go, but a foul here on Roberts, his second.
We've seen Junior Blunt shoot the ball extremely well this year, and every time he shot it well, he squared up to the hole, he catches it shooting in rhythm. Now he's forcing it just a little bit off balance that time, and he could be flinching because he's been knocked down twice, but he hasn't squared up and shot a good shot the last several times down the floor.
Dumont's free throw is good.
And the advantage goes to the Frogs inside. They cannot stay with Marlon Dumont, the rest in Dewar Fisher over there, so the Frogs can attack that. Billy's clubs annually go inside out. They take the ball into the low post and then kick it out for the shot.
Dumont has 13 on the night. Rebound tapped out and controlled by Duplessis. He's got 13. The guards have accounted for 16 points in this first half. But Billy Tubbs, his forwards, Herb, his starting forwards, Jamal Brown and Corey Valson, only 2 points in this first half.
And Jamal needs to probably get his scores on putbacks.
Darnell Bradley, right-hand corner. They swing it out to Corey Wilson for Northwestern State. 1:44 to play. Top of the circle, Duplessis. Flips it over left-hand side. Now to Lynch. Finds his man wide open. Baseline. Pulled. The shot's blocked by Brown. Lead pass, Blunt. Catches. Junior can't hang on, but he goes out of bounds. Off of Chris Lynch. And the Frogs retain possession with a minute 32 to go.
Exciting all the way around with a great challenge coming into the hoop, not letting him throw that down. Great lead pass. The ball just got away from Junior.
And Billy Tubbs upset because he thought Alan Polk used his left arm on the way up for the jam. Down low, Dumont turns, blocked right back in his face by Roberts. In the forecourt with it now as Wilson leans in, and it's swatted away. But an offensive foul here as drawing the charge is Junior Blunt on Corey Wilson.
Good job of Junior Blunt stepping in. You have to do that at times. Give up your body for the team. He did that real well. Corey Wilson's hurt right now.
38-33. Frogs trailing it by five with a minute 26 to play.
And Corey, a product of Eastern Hills High School here in Fort Worth, coached by Feli Donaldson.
Looks like it's his left wrist, possibly. Santee, right-hand side down to Blunt. Blunt to the elbow. Blunt in the lane. Hangs, shoots from eight to score.
Once again, off balance, but he did get the favorable roll that time.
38-35, a three-point lead now with a minute 9 to go.
Similar to the game that the Frogs had